Okay, so if you're taking any sort of math course like Algebra 1, Algebra 2, College Algebra, etc., probably one of the most important skills that you really need to master is factoring. So here we have a nice little problem, and the question is can you factor this? Now, this is not that difficult of a problem, and if you think you could factor this, go ahead and put your answer into the comment section. If you're totally lost, well, definitely stick around for a couple minutes because you definitely need to know how to do this. Again, one of the most important skills. Matter of fact, I would go as far as saying that you likely won't be able to pass your algebra course, Algebra 1, Algebra 2, etc., without being an expert at factoring. You gotta know how to factor. Very, very critical. So anyways, if you're not quite sure what to do here, well, stick around. I'm gonna explain this. Matter of fact, I'm gonna show you the correct answer momentarily, and then we're gonna go ahead and get into how to factor this particular expression. But before we get started, let me quickly introduce myself. My name is John. I'm the founder of TC Math Academy. I'm also a middle and high school math teacher. I've been teaching math for decades. I absolutely love helping people learn mathematics. And I'm going to tell you right now, all of you can be successful in math. And I'm especially speaking to those of you that struggle with math. If you failed math before, if you're struggling with math right now, if you hate math, hey, listen, I get it. If you're not having success in anything, you're going to get frustrated and you're not going to like it. But please do me a favor, do not give up hope. Don't quit, okay? Because there is absolutely a way for you to turn this around. There's three things you need to be successful in math. The first thing is you got to be willing to work hard. So if you're not willing to put in the effort, it's going to be tough to be successful in anything. The second thing you need is encouragement, and that's really important for those of you that are having a tough time in math. You need someone saying that you can do this. It's not going to be a waste of time for you to try then fail. I'm telling you that if you do things right, you can be successful, right? So you need encouragement. The most important thing you need, the third thing you need, is great math instruction. You need to learn from someone or something that you understand. Okay, now the way I like to teach math is in a non-technical way. All right, I could teach math in a very technical way, very, I can sound like a robot, like a textbook, but guess what? That's not going to help anyone out. Okay, there's a way to teach math where you can explain it, where all people understand, and you're not watering the subject down. Now, I've developed that kind of a style teaching over decades of teaching mathematics. So listen, if you need help with the current math course, or maybe some sort of special test that you're getting ready for that has math on it, and you're concerned about that math section, things like the GED, SAT, ACT, or teacher certification exam, or if you're homeschooling mathematics, check out my math help program. I'm going to leave a link to it in the description of this video. I literally have over 100 plus different math courses that span these categories and much, much more. I'm also going to leave links to my math notes in the description as well. So many students have average notes at best. You know who has the best notes? Those students who have grades like this. It's no mystery. There's absolutely a direct correlation. Your quality, your notes is going to go to the how well you do on test. Okay, so if you want to start improving in math, start taking better notes. But in the meantime, you can use my math notes if you like. And if this video helps you out, don't forget to like and subscribe, as that definitely helps me out. Okay, so we have 100x squared minus 16y squared. Let's go ahead and factor this, and here is the answer. Okay, so if you fully factor that expression, it's equal to this: 4 times 5x plus 2y times 5x minus 2y. That is the correct answer. Okay, so how did you do? Well, if you got this right, very impressive. Matter of fact, impressive enough for a nice little happy face and A plus, a 100%, and a few stars to celebrate your success with factoring today. Nice job. Okay, so what are we talking about here? Well, the secret to doing this problem involves this little formula right here, A squared minus B squared, and I'm going to give you the rest of the formula in a second. But before we get into this problem, okay, let's just very briefly talk about factoring in general. Okay, so here is the different skills that you need to know. And if you need help with factoring, which if you don't have down, you're not going to be, and I'm not trying to exaggerate here, you're likely not going to be able to pass your course, your algebra course, if you struggle with factoring. You got to get this taken care of, and you can do it, okay? But don't ignore it. So when we're talking about factoring skills in algebra, the first thing you need to learn is something called the greatest common factor. You got to understand how to factor out the GCF. Then after that, you're going to get into how to factor like things like trinomials, things that look like this, x squared plus 2x plus 1. Trinomials, there's two different type of trinomials. There's what we call case 1, where there's a 1 in front of the coefficient. And then you can have what I like to refer to as case 2s. So it would be like 3x squared plus 7x plus 9, where there's a number other than a 1 in front of that leading coefficient, the number in front of the x squared or y squared or whatever you're dealing with. I'm being a little bit sloppy here. I don't want to be a bad example. But anyways, you have to get trinomials down, how to factor trinomials. So you start off with greatest common factors, then you focus in on how to factor trinomials. And then from there, you start doing special factoring rules, okay? Special factoring rules, and that's what we're dealing with here. Examples of that would be the difference of two squares, a squared minus b squared. The rest of the formula is a plus b, a minus b, all right? So a squared minus b squared is equal to a plus b times a minus b. That's what we call the difference of two squares. And there's other special factoring formulas that you need to know. And then there's other more kind of advanced techniques that you'll need to know, like group factoring, etc. So this is kind of the way you want to approach it. Okay, so make sure you understand how to factor the GCF, then understand trinomials, and then all those special factoring rules, things like this, and then you can be ready for more advanced techniques. But you got to get this down because so many other additional topics in algebra rely on your ability to factor things. Okay, so this is the particular formula that we're going to be using, the difference of two squares. Okay, so just think about what I just said. The difference of two squares is one thing being squared minus another thing being squared. This is the difference of two squares, okay? A difference of two squares, and it's a squared minus b squared. So when you look at this situation, 100x squared minus 16y squared, we want to look for patterns when it comes to factorings. And it's almost a kind of a dead giveaway when you have something being squared and there's a subtraction sign in there. You want to be thinking the difference of two squared, a squared minus b squared. See if you can kind of have that, your situation fit into an a squared minus b squared scenario. Because if you can, then you can use the formula to factor that respective expression. Okay, so that's almost a kind of dead giveaway when you have two things being squared and being subtracted from one another. It's almost always an a squared minus b squared or difference of two squares situation. Okay, so we're looking at this, we're like, okay, I have 100x squared minus 16y squared. Here's the deal, here's the formula. But in order to use this formula, a squared minus b squared, I need to know what the a and b are equal to. So if I know what a is equal to and b is equal to, then I can just plug in those respective values into the formula and I will have the factors to the expression. So let's go ahead and do that right now. All right, so 100x squared minus 16y squared. So this is our a squared and this is our b squared. Okay, so we want to think of this in this way. Let me go and erase this. All right, so this is like our a squared minus b squared. So our a squared is equal to 100x. So this 100x represents our a squared, and this 16y squared represents our b squared. So how do I get a and b? Remember, I need the value of a and b, not a squared and b squared. Okay, I need a and b. So how do I solve this? Well, easy. All I need to do is simply take the square root of both sides. Okay, the square root of a squared is equal to a, and the square root of 100x squared is equal to 10x. Why? Because 10x times 10x gets you back to 100x squared. Now, just in case you didn't, you know, fully understand this, we can break this down further this way. 100x squared is the same thing as 100 times x squared, which is the same thing. We can split apart this square root this way, the square root of 100 times the square root of x squared. So again, you have to know these properties of square roots. The square root of 100 is 10, and the square root of x squared is x. So again, 10x. All right, so that's what a is equal to, and here b squared is equal to 16y squared. So to get b, simply take the square root of both sides. I'm going to get 4y. Okay, that would be the square root of 16y squared. So this is b and this is a. Now, as you get better at this and you deal with a more difference of two square situations, you don't have to do all of this. You could probably just easily look at this and be like, okay, this is 10x and this is 4y. But as long as you understand how to get both the a and b values so you can plug them into the formula, that's what counts. Okay, so let's go ahead and now plug this stuff in. So here, this again is following this a squared minus b squared pattern. Here's what a is equal to. Here's what b is equal to. So the difference of two squared is going to be equal to a plus b times a minus b. So this is simply just plugging everything in. So what is a? A is 10x. So we'll plug in 10x there. B is 4y, so we're going to have 10x plus 4y, and then here this is going to be a minus b, or 10x minus 4y, and these are the factors right here, okay? These two binomials are the factors of our expression, and we are done. Well, not quite, okay? Not quite. So if some of you had this as your answer, I bet you a lot of you had this as your answer. Because I'm such a nice math teacher, I might give you like 8 out of 10 points, okay? Maybe 7 out of 10 points. And a lot of you might be like, hey, what are you talking about, Mr. YouTube Math Man? I did this problem right. Give me all my points. Well, listen, I can't give you all this your points there because you haven't fully factored the factors. When you factor, you got to fully factors, and sometimes you can factor the factors. So let's go ahead and take a look at what I'm talking about here. So if you notice, the factors themselves, 10x plus 4y, they have two in common in terms of a common factor. So we can factor out the greatest common factor out of each of these respective binomials. So 10x plus 4y is the same thing as 2 times 5x plus 2y, right? Because if I distribute this 2 in, I get back to 10x plus 4y, and I can factor out a 2 over here as well. That leaves me with 5x minus 2y. Then, of course, I can go ahead and multiply. This is all multiplication, right? This is 2 times this times 2 times this factor. So we could just put this 2 times 2 right there, 4. Then we have our remaining factors right there. This is the complete full factorization of 100x squared minus 16y squared. You have to completely, fully factor, okay? When you're factoring anything, make sure you factor, first do whatever technique you're going to use, and then look at your factors, because very often you can factor the factor. Sometimes you can't, but, you know, just don't do a problem, especially with a difference of two squares. Be like, okay, I'm done. So if you did get this correct, if you got this right there, again, that is a good job. Okay, matter of fact, I'd probably even give you a happy face, but I certainly can't give you an A+. I might give you an A-. Good job. And if I told you, hey, you forgot to factor the GCF, you know what you would say? You say, I knew that. I probably heard that phrase, I knew that. I want to say I've heard this over the decades, maybe 100 million times, maybe not that many times, but, you know, a lot of times. And I'm sure I said that as well as a young math student. I knew that. Listen, just because you knew that, if you didn't answer it correctly on your work, well, guess what? You're not going to get full credit, even though you knew that. Okay. So anytime you are doing any math problem, you got to think through the problem completely, right? And the only way you're going to get better at math is to practice. And the only way you're going to get better at factoring is to practice a ton of problems. If there's anything that you should be doing a lot of, that I would strongly suggest that would be factoring problems. Because the better you get at factoring, the easier algebra is going to get. So if you need help with this stuff, I'm going to suggest that you check out like my Algebra 1 course. Even if you're in Algebra 2, I do teach factoring in Algebra 2. And do teach some factoring as well in pre-algebra, really the more advanced techniques, you kind of start really learning that in Algebra 1. So those are some recommendations if you need to improve in factoring. I also have additional videos on my YouTube channel on factoring as well, but you got to become an expert at factoring. This will make your algebra life much, much easier. Okay, so with that being said, I definitely wish you all the best in your mathematics adventures. Thank you for your time and have a great day.